Senator.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Are there persons in the audience who wish to speak in opposition to the tables?
My name is Chris Dorsey. I'm speaking in opposition to everything this body does. The consent agenda, again, is full of language that people don't understand, and it's bundled legislation that's bad for people that, you know, is just voted without any real consideration or even people understanding at all what the legislation is. What drives all this is the Economic Development Authority, which consists of representatives that own this council from the Federal Reserve Bank, which is the treasonous and unconstitutional institution that controls everything this government does. Dominion Power, we're talking about the river. The river is filthy and polluted, and the biggest polluter in the Commonwealth of Virginia is another representative on the Economic Development Authority, and that's Dominion Power, which has its headquarters here. They have tritium leaking from a earthquake damaged nuclear power plant. They spew all sorts of coal runoff and other pollutants and toxins into our water. And then I see that there is legislation about wastewater and the water treatment facilities. And first of all, I would like to demand that this body stop putting an industrial waste product known as fluoride into the water. It's not anything that's going to help your teeth. It's poison. But, the Fed and Dominion Power and representatives from the lobbying firms downtown that control the state legislature, like Williams and Mullen and McGuire Woods, they all direct these things, and they make money hand over fist every step of the way when they're carrying this out. It is theft to move forward with that West Hampton school project. I don't really want more obnoxious, loud construction noise in the neighborhood, and a worse footprint couldn't be left by any company other than and St. Mary's and Bonsecours. They stole from the city, and so did the Redskins, and Dan Snyder, will be locked up when the people get in control of the jails, because we don't really care who won the game yesterday. I'd like to say that any mention of Virginia Code 2.2 in this room is so ironic and ridiculous. I can't even believe people had the guts to bring this up. Alan Jackson over there, he's guilty in covering up massive balloting and election fraud engaged on behalf of the city. You're out of order.
No.
I'm making statements of fact.
You want off? We are not going. The rules of council were read to you. You will not speak about individual people sitting up here.
I'm making statements of fact about your criminal nature and about Alan Jackson's criminal nature. That's a statement of fact.
Thank you.
I presented this evidence to Judge Gibney.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Silver Person. I'm a citizen of Richmond, Virginia. There's a couple items I'd like to speak in opposition to. Items number 1 and number 13. Not number 1, number 2 and number 13. Number 1 is adding nuisances to our city code. You're going to add bats, rodents, insects, arachnids, vermin, including not limited to rats, mice, bees, flies, fleas, cockroaches, bedbugs, spiders, ants, silverfish, termites, and power post beetles. Mrs. Robertson asked a good question during the informal session. She asked, what's the penalty? Because as this ordinance says, under Section 2, it shall be unlawful for any person who owns or occupies property within the city to permit a nuisance as set forth in Subsection A of this Section 2 exist on such property. As you all know, within the last year, in order to clean up the code, you made it be a first-degree misdemeanor where items aren't defined. You could make this a fourth-degree misdemeanor, which carries a much shorter, a small penalty. I think it's just only fines, you could face a year in jail. $1,500 fine, that's what you're passing right here. You know, I don't think this is really been vetted very properly. You know, when you guys review papers, you really just look at them for 5 minutes and then they're sitting here for you guys to vote on every 2 weeks. This was considered an organizational development where I did not have an opportunity to comment because you don't allow comment at the organizational development meeting. I think that's a problem. You know, that's the only committee meeting where the majority of council members appear, and wouldn't it be great if citizens could talk to you guys offline, not at one of these formal meetings, in a committee environment? Well, you guys shoot yourself in the foot. You also hold that meeting before 5 o'clock when the majority of people that live in the city are at work. Number 13, that's the Monsters Redskins giveaway. You know, it's a ripoff. You're giving the school to Monsters to use for 60 years. I appreciate the city retaining ownership of the property. I disagree that the lease is too long. I think it's the longest lease that the city has with any private entity in the city. I think that's a dangerous precedent for us to have for economic development. I object to building a $9 million stadium for a billionaire, Daniel Snyder, the owner of the Redskins. He can build his own training stadium. Why is the city doing it? I heard that there are no reports that show a long-term economic impact from or benefit from sports events. I don't think this is a policy we're to pursue. The Commonwealth of Virginia has already given the Redskins $4 million. Why don't they kick some of that down to us to build their stupid training field? Thank you for the opportunity to comment.
Thank you, sir.
Madam Chairman, members of council, my name is Amy Swartz, Director of Preservation of Historic Richmond Foundation. Historic Richmond Foundation advocates for the protection of the architectural treasures of the city, and I'm here to talk about West Hampton School and its protection. We appreciate your inclusion of Historic Richmond in the process of the rehabilitation of West Hampton School and have already had a meeting with Bonsecours and their consultants. HRF strongly requests that before any bids are accepted, that the city transfers West Hampton School with strong conditions that an adaptive reuse of the building be a part of the deal with appropriate infill additions behind and around it to obtain necessary square footage. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Madam President.
Yes, sir, Mr. Jones.
May I ask the nice lady if she...
I believe Mr. Jones' question.
As you mentioned, Historic Richmond Foundation was considered to be a part of this arrangement.
Yes.
Have you had any indication that you would not be welcome to the table?
Not at this time. No, we've been welcomed by Bonsecours. We've had a meeting. We have another on calendar for this week. So things are progressing in the way that we are pleased.
Okay. That's all I wanted to hear. Thank you.
Is there anyone here who wishes to speak in favor of any of these papers? Okay, back to council for discussion. Call the questions for
council is voting on the consent agenda as presented with items 2, 3, 6 through 14, 16, 18, and 19. Mr. Samuels, would you be willing to make a motion?
Yes, I do.
Council is voting on these items as presented in the consent agenda. Mr. Conner?
Aye.
Mr. Samuels?
Aye.
Madam Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Jewell?
Aye.
Ms. Newville?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Mr. Tyler?
Aye, with the exception of item number 12, I have a conflict of interest and cannot vote on.
Madam President Graziano?
Aye.
The consent agenda has been adopted.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. I believe we have 3 expedited resolutions. Thank you.